wondering when you'd show up.
Welcome to paradise. If your idea of paradise is a place where a sick, creepy voyeur can spy on anyone in the country with total impunity. Actually, I guess that kind of is the American dream, huh? Anyhow, I digress. You have made a big name for yourself. And that name is Dangerous Idiot, who's just waiting to get robbed. So do yourself a favor and put some of that not-so-hard-earned money into real estate. Then you can be a real player, just like me. Jesus, as I say that, I realize how depressing and pathetic I've become. I'm a mess, you know. Take pity on me. End it now. Kill me. Ah! And I thought it was funny. Okay, well, like I said, put some of that money into property. There's already people who want to rob you. Soon enough, there will be people who want to kill you. And if anybody gets particularly fresh, just give me a shout. I can put a bounty on them, and every whack job in the state will want to get them off your back for you. Of course, you never know. Maybe someone asked me to do it to you. Well, that was awkward. How can I be of service? Call me back when you've figured out how that brain of yours works.
Don't say anything. I don't know you. Or maybe I do. I don't remember. I got a job. A job that's so hot, we're gonna bury it in an ex-government facility under about 100 feet of desert. You think you're up for it? Buy the facility on Mays Bank and I'll meet you over there. This is bigger than any bank job we could ever pull. Okay, you own the facility. If you've got a crew, get them together, head over there, and come down to the presentation room. I've got someone to introduce you to. He's richer than God, and he needs a team to break down the toughest security walls in the country. So, of course, he called some bank robbers.
What up, wussy? I saw you racing. Not bad, but it's time to move out of the blue chips into something more volatile. Up the risk, up the gain, you feel me? I'm talking parachuting! San Andreas is full of totally rad jump spots, so crank it up a notch! Dominator out!
This is a courtesy call from Meriwether Security Consulting. We're expanding our domestic operation and want you to be aware of our exciting new munitions delivery service. Anytime, anywhere, your Second Amendment rights are just a phone call away. Simply dial this number, pay a fee, and one of our agents will deliver ammunition straight to you. More services will be available shortly, so watch this space.
is a courtesy call from Trevor Phillips Industries to tell you that you've messed up very badly. My boss is very angry, and you really would not like him when he's angry. He insists you come to our HQ in Sandy Shores and explain yourself. He told me to tell you to bring knee pads and mouthwash. Not sure what that means, but I would hurry if I were you. Which, right now, I'm glad I'm not.
How can I help you?
How can I help you? What can I do for you?
IAA departmental softball is now every second weekend.
Yes, yes, come in. Have a seat anywhere. This is the one room in the country where we cannot be recorded.
Can I take this mask off now?
Do you know Avon Hertz?
Avon Hertz. Yes, the Avon Hertz. Don't act all weird. I'm just a normal genius. I do very normal things like kite surf with presidents and date B-list actresses. I bleed real tears. This is real hair. I program, and I have actual emotions. I'm sort of like one of those things that is good at lots of things. Why isn't this person talking?
Just don't worry about it. Mr. Hertz took his first company public when he was 22 years old.
21 and three quarters. I was worth $1.5 billion by the time I was 25. I'm trying to save the world, for fuck's sake, man, if it'll let me.
Avon was helping the IAA. The government.
Helping the government. I was trying to be the government. My work with artificial intelligence. Thinking only better. That's my slogan, by the way. I was trying to guide the government through a security and ethics nightmare it had stumbled into. When whoosh, I'm told, no thanks. It's a fucking joke, but I'm not laughing.
Avon is worried that someone's trying to start a war.
I'm not worried about it. I'm certain of it. The only problem is, I just don't know who exactly. And worse, Clifford doesn't know who.
Clifford, that's his supercomputer.
It's a neural network of supercomputers. Clifford is a problem-solving facility. Say hello, Clifford.
You're embarrassing me, Avon. I'm blushing.
Give Clifford data and no more problem. Clifford was onto something, but now the data is gone.
Gone?
It has to be the Russians, or the North Koreans, or the Iranians, or the Chinese using a proxy agent. The fact is, if we cannot figure out who is behind these data breaches, then Clifford is useless.
If we can get paid, of course we can help.
There are three data thefts I need you to unbreach, re-breach, broach. I'm a natural communicator.
You're getting off topic.
No, this is the topic. How I've been treated. How I've been mistreated. It's an American tragedy. Kill the clever genius so that numbskulls could take cheap bribes. Yeah, I'll pay. I'll pay whatever it takes.
We'll need serious cash. Six figures, minimum.
No problem. My share price is through the roof. Look, three problems. Three easy enough solutions.
Could you stop talking like you're giving a keynote speech, please?
Do I do that?
Yes!
Three data thefts. 250 trillion data points in enemy hands. Three simple solutions. One, data courier. Murdered on the streets of Los Santos. Bodies at the morgue.
The morgue. You'll have to steal an ambulance to get in there.
Old-fashioned. Analog. I love it. Retro. Problem two, Four of these vans are beaming vast amounts of previously secure military data. You'll need cars to track them down. I have a sort of friend who has some cars you can borrow here.
Okay, that sounds easy enough. What's the third?
The big new server farm in Palomino has been compromised. I'm certain of it. No one believed me, and I have no idea how to prove it, but if someone could get inside...
Just give me a minute. I know these stealth helicopters. These things. Huh? Now, Avon, these all do seem a bit random.
Of course they seem random, because you are not a supercomputer. Clifford will solve it for us. Just give us more data about the data so we can data it.
All right, well, get to work and good luck.
Pleasure to meet you. You look nice in that shirt, Avon. I like your hair.
Thank you. Progkillclifford.exe.
Sending you the location now. In case it wasn't clear, you're gonna need the ambulance and the paramedic gear to get into the coroner's office. You know, to get the agent's body, to get the data, yeah? Okay, get to work.
You need something, huh? One of your rides? Let me know. It's coming at you.